Hello and happy Sunday to all my many friends, also to my many enemies. Once again, this is your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, coming back at you with another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning into the program on today. And if you're not yet a subscriber to Roosevelt Sounds Off, please go down and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime I drop a brand new video right here on YouTube. Not going to be before you too long on today, but just wanted to bring you something. Well, matter of fact, it comes with a question. I know I haven't been on in a couple of weeks, but you know, just been busy, you know, just living life. And you know, I hope that you all are doing the same thing too, and I hope that you are actually enjoying life, and I hope that you're actually having a wonderful weekend and happy Sunday. The reason for this video, as you know, today is October 31st, which, you know, all of us, including the world, will call Halloween. And I was asked a question by one of my subscribers. Thank you, Lady D, for that question. You know, super shout out to her for asking me this question, because she says that she has never seen me ever give my opinion about it before. But what is my opinion about Halloween, as well as other holidays? Well, ladies and gentlemen, what can I say? That when I was growing up as a child, I know, you know, that my parents, you know, allowed me and my brother to observe Halloween. Now, we never went trick-or-treating, but, you know, she would always buy us costumes, and then we'd always dress up, and she'd always give us a whole bunch of candy. And whenever there was a program or a Halloween party at school, we were always allowed to attend. And I would have to say that the times of my childhood, or those times, were a whole lot of fun, at least for me. Because at the time, even though I believed that my parents did indeed do their best, and what it is that they tried to, you know, teach and instill into my brother and I, that I don't believe that they had the true meaning of holidays like Halloween and Christmas or Thanksgiving or even Valentine's Day for that matter. It wasn't until I think I was around a teenager when I came into the truth about what some of these holidays were. And the truth is, if you're ready for it, it's a whole lot of these holidays, like Halloween, Thanksgiving, especially like Christmas, Easter, were pretty much pagan holidays. Halloween was originally called Samhain, or All Hallows Eve, or Eve of the Holy Ones. You know, that's the night where legend says that Samhain releases all of the evil spirits into the world. And the reason why people dress up is because if they didn't want to get devoured by these evil spirits, they had to look like something or someone else. Even in a whole lot of the traditions that people practice in Halloween, whether it's the jack-o'-lantern, whether it's bobbing for apples, trick-or-treating, where it pretty much said that, you know, you knock on someone's door, and, well, the story goes, is that a spirit would knock on people's door, and they would request food or fruit or something else, and if they were not given the food or fruit by the homeowner, then they would play a trick on a person. So basically, you know, that's where you get trick-or-treating from. But I do know it's something that is for the kids, and I know the children actually enjoy dressing up, because I guess some people, they don't really completely trip on it, because it's just one day when you can be someone else and kind of get outside of yourself. And I know a whole lot of churches even just observe it. Like in my church, and even in other churches, they don't call it trick or treat, they call it trunk or treat. To where they have members of the church decorate their cars in all kinds of crazy colors and everything, and then they have all the cars have a whole trunk full of candy, and all the children can go and get like all the candy. I know that the church I belong to now does it, and under the church I belong to before did it, not a church I belonged to before that, which was a sanctified church, didn't observe any holidays at all, whether it was Christmas or Easter. That's when I was in a sanctified church. A whole lot of people always ask me, well, what did you do on Christmas when you're in a sanctified church? What did you do on December 25th? I mean, dude, it was just like any other day, I guess. You know, just like today, it's just like any other day. You know, Christmas, December 25th, is just like any other day. Because I came into the knowledge of what some of these holidays were. Because even though, like I said before, my parents did their best, they might not have had all of the wisdom and knowledge that we do today. Because today, if you want to know almost anything about everything, all you have to do is pick up your trusty little cell phone and hit Siri or Google, and you know, you can find out whatever. And even back in my day, all of the stuff that I'm telling you now, even a few things that I just told you about Halloween, you can find in your trusty encyclopedia or world book. Things like that. But the only problem is a whole lot of people just don't want, I guess, knowledge, because they just want to look at the good side of things, that it's something for children, it's something wonderful, something that they look forward to. But I think that we have to question and look behind all things. We have to look behind things like Halloween or Christmas, or even what goes on in everyday society. Ever since I have been on this kind of mission, I know ever since I was a teenager, when I started discovering the truth about a whole lot of things, then a whole lot of people begin to talk and begin to say things. They begin to say, oh, Roosevelt, he's a troublemaker, or he's a rabble-rouser, or he's just beginning to get too woke, and he's beginning to see the bad side of things, and he's letting certain things he's coming into color his attitude about everything. Oh yeah, blah, 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 blah. But I guess that's just something that I do. And for over a year and a half, me, as long as other people on social media and even other YouTubers have been sounding the alarm about the COVID-19 conspiracy and the vaccine conspiracy. And I'll always tell you, what do I always say? Look for the lie. Because I personally believe, this, it might make me a bad person for saying it, but you know me, this is my show, I say it anyway. I personally do not believe that close to 700,000 people died from COVID-19. I really don't. I really believe it's far less than that, but they just boosted up the numbers as a scheme and a plot and a ploy to pretty much take our freedoms, to trample on religious freedoms, to trample on our rights, and also set up this vaccine, or known as the jab or the shot or the poison, to use it as a way to control us. Anytime you can talk about people losing their jobs and losing their livelihoods if they don't take the shot, it's got to be something a whole lot more behind it. But a whole lot of stupid, ignorant people don't want to look at these things and don't want to research. You just want to go along with what the lamestream media is saying and not questioning what is truly behind all of it. So as a teenager, when I began to find out the truth about like Halloween and Christmas and Valentine's Day, oh yeah, I mean, when I got this truth, I wanted to share it with everyone. But at the same time, you know, looking at it from the other side, I do admit that Halloween celebrations, when I was a child, it gave me a great amount of anticipation, gave me a great amount of joy. It may be during this time, especially after the year and a half that we have had of them taking just about everything away from us, life never ever being the same ever again. All because of this whole thing that they created of COVID-19, which is the Democratic Party's and Joe Biden's and Bill Gates' virtual wonderful wet dream. After a year of this, and a year and a half, I think that a whole lot of us just want to, you know, halfway get back to normal. And we need some joy, and we need some goodness. And I do actually really believe that's how come, because a whole lot of us was raised with this lie, that our parents taught us that there was a such thing as a Santa Claus. But personally speaking, I know as a grown person who's 47 years old now, that there is no such thing as a Santa Claus. No, ladies and gentlemen, no big 400-pound white man is going to come down your chimney and put gifts underneath your Christmas tree. No, it's not going to happen. If anything, if I had children, I would teach my children about the glory and the honor of God and about the blessings of God, that you have these gifts because myself, as well as your mother, love you, and this is what we got you. God is the one who empowered us and strengthened us to get wealth in order to buy you these things and to do these things for you during this special time, which Christmas is the birth of Jesus Christ, or so they say, because at the same time, we know that Christ was not born on December 25th. So I would give glory and honor to God, I believe. I wouldn't give glory and honor to a Santa Claus. But at the same time, I can understand why our parents did it, because they were trying to give us some kind of fantasy and something good. And I guess it's just something to look forward to. But as far as Halloween goes, since this is what we are talking about on today, that if you look at it and you do your research, that it is the highest day on the Satanic Witches calendar. It was started by the Druid Celtic culture, and it pertains to a lot of witchcraft. But a whole lot of people, out of tradition or habit or whatever it is, are willing to ignore these facts. Even a whole lot of people in the church want to ignore these facts, all because they say it's just supposed to be fun. But I really do believe that churches and pastors, preachers, bishops, apostles, evangelists, whatever you want to call yourself, need to get back to the place where we teach our children the truth about these kind of holidays. And don't bring this stuff into God's house. Anytime you are glorifying the highest day on the Satanic Witches calendar, then you as a church are glorifying evil and a part of something evil. And it does say in scripture that you aren't supposed to partake in another person's evil deeds. Even though I can understand it's supposed to be fun or whatever, and I know children love it, because one thing about it, just like I was when I was a kid, they love candy and they love treats and just love overall just to have some fun. But I do believe that we need to get back to telling the truth. And no matter what it is that we hear, whether it pertains to something in government, whether it pertains to something in religion, whether it pertains to a certain holy day or holiday, like a Halloween or Christmas or Easter or Valentine's Day, that we need to actually and support those who seek out the truth. Whenever we hear something, we need to research, we need to question, and we need to ask ourselves, what is the hidden agenda of what certain people might be trying to do in our name? And I do believe, instead of turning against people just because they come and tell you the truth, instead of calling people rebellious or a rabble-rouser and trying to take children's fun, oh, you're taking, if you teach that in the church, you'll be taking fun away from the little children, from the little children. You know, instead of looking at it like that, I think that we need to teach our children the truth. Teach them what the truth is about these holidays. Teach them what the truth is behind certain things, and try to line it up with scripture, because as they get older, if you raise them like they're supposed to be raised, then when they get older, I think that that's a teaching that will stay with them, and the scriptures say that they will not depart from it. And most of all, I do believe that we need to pray for and support those brave souls who seek the truth. So that is what I had today, and that's what I had to bring you, is my opinion about it. That even though it gave me a great amount of joy and expectation as a child, that when you get grown and you find out the truth, I think that you have to change certain things and pass it down to the next generation, and they can pass it down to their children. Even though I don't really believe that our parents had anything bad or, you know, evil intended in letting us observe this particular holiday. But when we get grown, we have a choice as to what we pass on to our children and what we do about situations right now. So, as I get ready to close this video, I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in. And if you like this video, please do me a favor and give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And please tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And until the next video, this has been your friend, brother, and humble servant Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families.